Guys, good morning. I'm gonna add this onto my vlog because I haven't finished editing it yet, and it's actually 9:30. I woke up less than half an hour ago and I'm in the Starbucks drive-thru. Like, it's a crime, but they've released, so my, as you guys saw in my Vegas vlogs, my favorite drink, the Dragon and Mango Refresher, they've brought it to the UK. They brought it to the UK today. I'm up at early doors in the Starbucks queue getting my Dragon and Mango Refresher. I've ordered two. I've ordered one large one and one medium one because I'm gonna put one in the fridge. Because you absolutely best believe I'm saving that for later today. Because this drink is the love of my life. Like, if I had a love of my life, it would be this drink. So I look disgusting. I'm not wearing a bra. I'm not wearing any underwear. I'm just wearing my pajama top and some joggers. And I'm not even wearing proper shoes. I'm just wearing my little Dolly flats. Because I was like... And I had to sneak out of bed. I had to creep over Connor and sneak out of bed. He's still asleep at home. To get here. So this has been a mission. And let's hope it's successful. Because I'm dying for one of these drinks, and excuse my nails, so I had to put my own little press on nails on, and the guy in front of me just will not move. I had to put like some press on nails on because I've had to sacrifice. I can't get my nails done twice in 1 month, you see, and they fell off, and so I'm gonna have to go to her just before I go to Zante, which is in like 3 weeks. I have to go to Zante. So I'd rather get my nails done for Zante and just struggle for the rest of the month. So I've got a couple of things coming up in May. So I just wanted to update you guys just on the end of the vlog. I've got a couple of things coming up in May. You know me, I always try my best to do vlogging, but I just haven't done anything for the last few weeks. So there just hasn't been anything to vlog. And I was just like, there's no point in me vlogging because I haven't got anything to do. So what I'm gonna, but I have got a couple of things coming up. I've actually booked Post Malone on Thursday next week. So I'm going to see Post Malone. So I'll vlog Post Malone. And then I'm also going to a Disney experience in mid-May, where it's like a Disney sensory experience type thing. And I thought that'd be really fun. So me and my sister are going to go to that. It's only something small. Like, it wasn't expensive. It was like £17 a ticket. But so me and my sister are going to go and do that. And then I've got Zante. So those are the couple of things I'm doing this month. So there'll be a couple of vlogs on that. I have to pack and do some shopping as well. So I might do a shopping vlog on what I buy. So yeah, a couple of little vloggies coming up. Package secured. I'm so excited, guys. I got a little drink for the train. These, by the way, unreal. Unreal. Sat waiting for the train, got our tickets, and we're just gonna head straight to Greenwich, I think, and we're gonna go to a couple of bars, have a few drinks, and then we're gonna get some dinner. We're gonna chance our arm and try and get into a restaurant. We haven't booked anything. We're just gonna try and get something to eat. I'm not even joking, I have a tango and rice cakes in my bag. Because I'm so hungry. I have rice cakes in my bag, which Connor said I was crazy for, but you know.
You bring your rice cakes, I don't mind.
I'm in my skinny girl era. I need my rice cakes.
Eat your rice cakes, babe.
Love my rice cakes. And then a Tango Paradise Punch, which, by the way, they're really good. I don't know if they're limited edition ones though, but a Tango edition. But they're really nice, so got them from Tesco. I'm so excited. Because this is my birthday present, isn't it? This is what you bought me for my birthday, didn't you?
It is indeed.
Yeah, Connor bought me these for my birthday, so even though my birthday was in February, but we're celebrating it from 6 till 10 this evening. I'm so excited. Sorry, I'm so excited.
Thank you.
much. I'm so happy. I can't wait for this on. The t-shirt was £40 and there was another one that I really wanted, but I ended up getting this one. So we're heading to get some food. We're gonna go to ZZ's, get some pizza and a chips and an alcoholic beverage, because that's what we're in need of, isn't it, babe?
Absolutely.
That is what we're in need of. Merch secured, now we just need to secure the food. And I'm gonna put this t-shirt on and take this off, because obviously, like, obviously we're sat in ZZ's, gonna have some food. I think we're just gonna have pizza and chips, to be honest with you, but oh, someone's colored on the menu. So we're currently sat in ZZ's waiting for our food. So we've ordered some garlic bread and some pizzas and some chips. And I secured the merch, so I'm gonna put that on. Obviously once I've eaten, because I don't wanna spill food down it or something. We're trying to get I have O2 priority, so we also get O2 priority access into the bar and that they have, and also priority access so we don't have to wait in the regular queue. We're just currently getting the barcodes for that, so hopefully we can get in without the priority having to stand in the regular queue. Maybe, because I did order the tickets on O2 priority, so I'm hoping. Maybe. So I'm just waiting now for food. Super excited. Super excited. The queue for the merchandise wasn't that long. However, it is only about 3 o'clock. We've got here a little bit early, so we can just get some food, relax, have a couple of drinks before the show. Show starts at 6. But obviously, Post Malone probably won't be on until like 9. It took us quite a while to get here from Stevenage. You had to get like one train and 2 tubes. Got our garlic bread.
This is food.
How big are these pizzas? This is unbelievably big. We should have just shared one. These are too big. Just having a little drink.
Cheers.
I'm in my t-shirt. I'm just waiting now. Just drinking. All the people that are starting queuing over there to get
all the people that I've just shown you over there are queuing to get to the very, very front, whereas we've got seats that are near the stage but up and kind of to the side of it. So I don't know what our view's going to be like. I'm hoping it's okay and that it's not like behind the stage or something. So because I looked on that seat finder app and I can't find a view of our seats now, because I'm a bit nervous.
Guys, we've managed to get a table. Managed to actually get a table. And so now we're just people watching, which is my favourite pastime. I love to people watch. So we're just people watching. We're all bar one, having a few drinks, and just people watching. It's just so... I just love people watching. It's so interesting.
So people watching. Our people watching me.
Guys, we're heading over to H now.
H. What hotel?
H Hotel. Because that's where we are being let in. What? Guys, I feel like we're trekking around the whole arena.
We've done 2 laps so far, guys, getting them miles in.
Getting them steps in, aren't we?
We just love walking around O2.
But we are literally the only people that walk around all day. What? We're in H, so we're the furthest entrance.
We've gone past H.
No, we haven't. H is this way. No, it's not. It's like you're an idiot. Do you know that? Longest one ever. So just done security, which was really easy. We've just done security, which is really easy and really smooth. Just here at entrance H. So now we are heading up to find our seats.
Selfie. Bosh.
That's me, guys. Here I am doing my vlog. Caught in 4K. Vlogging. So this is what it looks like inside. Oh, it's not that busy.
We're in.
So we're 113, which is the furthest one back here. And the fact that there's no people concerns me on how shit. No, we're this way. The fact that there's no people here. It's concerning.
Actually, I can't even fit on the camera.
Oh my god. 398. Wait, 394? So this is the view from our seat, which I think is really good. Guys, we are so close to the stage. Smile, Connor. We're so close to the stage.
We're going to do that.
Okay. Oh, well, look at that. Look at that, guys. They're so close. Guys, look, you can see backstage. If I see Post Malone, I'm going to be so happy. Little back there, just creeping away. Look at that. You can see backstage. We're so close to the stage. It's starting to fill up now. Guys, look, they've got all the... That's it there, look. He's in a pink outfit, and they're all ready to come on stage now. They're getting on the stage set up. This is Swae Lee and his brother, so it'll be Ray Schmerd and them both together, so it's quite exciting. They're actually taking little pictures down there. You can't see it, but they're taking pictures before they go on stage, which is really funny. Look.
If you're ready for Ray Sherman, I need you to put your lights up right now. Make some noise if you're ready for Ray Sherman right now! Swae Lee Slim Jimmy! London, it's a big party right now with Sherman.
My name is also Richard Post. And I came to play some shitty songs and party a little bit while we do it, ladies and gentlemen. How we feeling tonight, man? I gotta say, I've been a lot of places in the world, and this is gotta be one of my favorite fucking places to play. And I gotta say, it's so fucking cool. The fact that y'all came out, y'all could be anywhere in the fucking world, and y'all came tonight means the fucking world to me. And I guess what I'm trying to say is I love you so fucking much, and let's party. Can you pray on every mistake? you. I would like to say the biggest fucking congratulations to each and every single one of you. Like I mentioned before, it's been a long time since we've been able to run around, and I just wanted to say how fucking cool it is to be able to go outside and go to a show together and just fucking be with beautiful people and just fucking celebrate life together. It's the most beautiful fucking thing in the world, and I'm so fucking grateful and so appreciative of you guys coming tonight. So cheers to y'all, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. That being said, I'd like to play a couple oldies but a couple goodies for y'all tonight. Becoming friends with a beautiful man, an amazing artist, and a talented vocalist. And we made a song together. And I know we're not the only two people who felt a little bit cooped up over these years, ladies and gentlemen.
King's Cross, St. Pancras, and now we're enjoying a McDonald's.
We've only got Venice chips and a drink,
and I may have snuck a McFlurry in there, and obviously some ketchup, because you can't have the chips without the ketchup, if you know what I mean. But I've snuck a McFlurry in there. We've just had to run for this train, and then the train got cancelled, so we were like, obviously we're going to go and get a McDonald's. I'm sure as of what you saw from the videos, like, it was absolutely insane. That concert was unreal, insane. I'll do a little overview when I get home, but I just wanted to update you guys on where we are, what we're doing. We're gonna start heading home soon. But yeah, we've got a little McDonald's to get us through.
It is the next day. The voice is not really existent. but I thought I'd just do like a little overview in terms of Post Malone. That, and excuse my little press on nails as well. That was one of the best performances that I think I've ever seen. I think Coldplay was better because they had all the bands and stuff. Like it was, yeah, that, well, I think it was better in terms of a different genre, but Post Malone's my favourite artist, and he's been my favourite artist for about 7 years. So to finally see him in person was, oh my God. And to be so close to him as well. We were so close to him on stage. So to be so close to him and to have admired him for 7 years and then to just finally hear his music live was just really, really nice. It was a really nice moment. I thoroughly enjoyed it. So yeah, it was amazing. I think he had all this, so he had like loads of fire and fireworks, and the fireworks were literally going off inside the stadium, which was insane. But it was so, because we were at the side of the stage, right, so we could feel the heat from the fire, and I was like, oh my God, I was boiling. I was like, oh my God, this is so hot. But we were in kind of a rush to get home, so I didn't really have much time to record. In terms of after that, obviously we had our McDonald's and then we came home. And then overnight I've developed Mount Everest on my face, which is fine. But yeah, what an amazing performance. It was really, really good and absolutely an experience that I would 100% do again. Yeah, was a really amazing experience. He had some Sway Lee, I think it's Ray Shimerd or something, but that's Sway Lee and his brother. But Sway Lee was amazing. Their beginning opening act was fantastic. That was really, really good as well. I just think the whole experience yesterday was just a really nice experience. I had such a good day. Obviously, that was my birthday present. So, you know, best birthday present. I really, really enjoyed it. So, in terms of next on the vlogs, I think I'm going to keep this vlog running and maybe just do like a little bank holiday weekend with me. I had recorded another vlog, but as me, as always, I record the vlogs and then literally just forget to edit them because I'm useless and have literally no time on my hands at all to edit vlogs. So I try my best to edit them, but a lot of the time I don't really actually have the time to edit the vlogs that I film. What I might do is include some of the clips that I recorded over the time that I did another vlog and put them into this one, because I tried the new Starbucks dragon fruit drink, which actually is the one that you guys saw me drink obscene amounts in Vegas. They brought it to the UK, which made me so, I was literally so happy. Like, it's a joke. Like, I was so happy. So I did do a little video of me doing that. I also tried the raspberry cloud frappuccino, but that was ages ago. But I also recorded that as well. So I might include my little Starbucks trips in here. It's going to be all over the place, but it would not be my vlog if it wasn't. If it wasn't all over the place and you were taken back in time to me driving through the Starbucks drive-thru, which is basically my second home at this point. So, it is now Saturday, and I am driving to Tesco's because it is my sister's birthday tomorrow and I'm making her birthday cake. So my sister's going to be 18, like, where is that gone? I remember when I was 18. So like, I'm like, oh my God, I can't believe you're 18 now. So I'm driving to go and get some cake mix to make her birthday cake with. So I'm thinking of like, I don't know whether I want to do like a heart cake or a two-tier cake. That is what I'm in decisions with at the minute. I'm thinking I'm probably going to do a heart cake. But I also kind of want to do a two-tiered cake, but I also am like, am I going to mess it up? Maybe I won't even do a two-tiered, maybe I'll just do one big cake. I don't know. Well, that was a bit bumpy. I don't know. So up in the air at the minute about what I'm going to do. I've got some inspo online. I've got on Pinterest and I've popped in a bit of inspo about what I want to do in terms of her cake. So I think I'm just going to pick one and go for it. My sister's very gothic, so I am going black cake, red velvet in the middle with like a dark red. I really want to do this like dark red drip around the side of the cake. Now I know that you have to do like you have to use like melted chocolate for that, so I probably would do that. I have white chocolate luckily that I can use to melt and make a nice drip around the side of the cake. I've spent a lot of money on Amazon for no reason on like a cake board, some spatulas, some like icing pipes, like everything. Like, I've really gone out to try and make this cake, so I'm gonna get lots of cake mix because just in case I mess up the first one, I then want to be able to go ahead and do the second one and not having to keep going back out to Tesco's to buy more ingredients. So that's the plan. So we're just heading to Tesco's now and gonna get some red velvet cake mix. I just don't really have the time to make the cake from scratch, so I'm just gonna buy some cake mix. Plus I always find that the Betty Crocker cake mixes, they're always nicer than the ones that I personally can make. I'm not a baker, so I'm not, well, I can bake, but I'm not a baker. Do you know what I mean? Like, I my profession is not baking cakes. So just for the sake of ease and knowing that I can't give anyone food poisoning from cake mixes, I'm happy just doing that. I've got bloody Mount Everest on my face. So this appeared yesterday when we went to Post Malone. and I've been putting Sudocrem on it, but it's really sore. But I have quite bad skin anyway, but it's doing quite well at the minute. Like, I've only, in terms of, this is all scarring now. This is scarring I've always had on my face, but now I've got a new one. I just have to try and not pop my spots, but that's an impossible task in itself because I love popping my spots. And like a shoulder back massage booked in. I'm taking my mum to the spa just before her honeymoon that she's going on literally this week. My mum's going on honeymoon next week, and so I'm taking her to the spa just before. We were going to go before her wedding, but I said no, we'll go before your honeymoon. Nice little honeymoon glow. So we're going to the spa next week, and I've booked a facial in just because I really need my skin at the moment. So let's go into Tesco. It's like Piccadilly Circus in there this morning. And there's like four spiders hanging from the ceiling. For what reason? So I spent £20. £20. Oh, I need to get petrol. Fine. I spent £20 and we'll go home and start baking.
Guys, I got carried away. I got too excited and I started. So I'm already on my first batch. I lined my tins and I'm just whisking everything up now. Sorry, my partner's boyfriend. My boyfriend's on a call. But I got a bit carried away and I'm whisking. I think we're all good. So this is the first batch, literally been whisked and finished. I don't think it's lumpy. I just want to double check because I can see some lumps, but I think it's just air pockets. So we're going to line the first tin. It's like a cooking show. It's like Lauren's cooking show. So when making a cake, swear by these, so you can't really see what's going on. Now you're in the action. So I'm gonna line this tin. Excuse my Donald Duck top because I don't mind actually getting this dirty, which is why I'm wearing it. So I'm gonna start by just this cake is gonna be like quite a few layers. I want it to be thick, so I'm using a smaller one because I want it to rise up more, because I want to try and make as minimal layers as I possibly can. I didn't grease the tin. It'll be fine. So what I do as well is I bang it on the side, that sounds really bad, so it gets out all the air pockets. Now I'm going to do the second round. I have to just remember to grease this side of the tin. Don't know why I didn't do that. I'm hoping it will be, normally these things, it will be absolutely fine. But to grease the tin, I take a little bit of kitchen roll. And I'm actually doing this on top of my cooker at the minute. But I take a little bit of that. Some baking spread and a bit of this, and I literally just rub it on the kitchen roll and just rub it around the side of the tin, so this just stops it sticking to the tin, which this other one's probably going to do. But luckily I've got four boxes of this velvet cake mix, so if it goes wrong the first time, that's fine. I've never ever made a cake like this before in my life, so I don't know how this is going to turn out. But listen, it's the first time for everything, and I'm hoping I'll get a bit of beginner's luck. Guys, what a palaver this cake situation. I've had to change clothes because I ruined my top, but what a palaver this has been, this cake situation. So I got the cake because I wanted to just get it all done and then I'll ice it on camera. But basically this one's actually just quite the one, so you should be really careful, but this one's cooling. But when I took it out, it fell in half, didn't it? stress. It's gonna be fine. So I'm just waiting for them all to cool now, and then I'm gonna put a bit of sugar syrup on them, and then we're gonna ice it and decorate it. So I'm just gonna show you guys what I've got for the filling and the icing and the actual decoration in terms of the cake. So I literally bought everything off Amazon. So I bought like a whole piping bag set with nozzles. I bought happy 18th birthday sign. I bought these to go on it because my sister's a little bit of a smoker. So I bought these to go on it. And the actual filling is going to be this rich cream cheese style filling because it's a red velvet cake. So I want to do it authentically, but I will be making a black buttercream. I got one of those like, I'm going to show you guys, wait.
Cake smoother, because I really wanted this cake to go right, so I bought, okay, that literally didn't even open. I bought everything that I needed. I'm not even a baker, but I bought everything that I needed to try and get it to go right. So I bought these like little, and basically you turn the cake and you just, I've been watching lots of cake videos. I got the sticks to go in the middle of it to hold it up. I bought a cake board and a cake box. And then I bought some white food colouring. And this black food colouring. This like black icing colour. I bought black and white. Because I have red already. But I bought white because I didn't know whether or not I wanted to write happy birthday on it. So I'm not actually even going to need this. I'm just going to need the black. And then that's about it. I'm going to make the icing. Because... oh, a bit windy. I'm gonna make the icing myself, like a buttercream, black buttercream icing. I've been watching some videos on how to get that right, so hopefully this should be quite successful.
Guys, this is what we're working with. I'm put them on the window so they cool quicker. But this cake turned out amazing. This one and this one both have sugar syrup on. As you can see, I've tried to stick this one back on, but I think I'm just going to stick it back with buttercream. The other one's over there. That one was a fail. It's fallen off again. I think I'm just going to stick that one back on with buttercream. But I made a little sugar syrup. As you can see, it's got bits of cake in it. To go around the edges so that it just doesn't crumb as much when I'm applying the icing. But I think this one's turned out the best. But yeah, they're coming along nicely. It's all coming along quite well. So I'm going to try and ice it later tonight. But at the minute, this is what we're working with. I just need this one to cool a bit more before I can put the syrup on. But yeah, very happy with it so far.
Look at that, guys. I'm back in my car. Wow. I'm in the KFC drive-thru. Yeah, that's where it's gotten to today. I didn't want to cook. I was like... no. So I was like to Connor, do you want a KFC? And he said, of course I want a KFC. So I was like, stun, I'll go get a KFC. So I'm now sat in the KFC drive-thru.
Guys, this is what I made out of it. You're not even going to believe it. The drama that I've just had. So I've literally just put lettuce in it with a bit of chicken, and Connor gave me a bit of his chicken.
So waited over an hour for my KFC in my car in total. When it came, okay, I asked for 4 strips. They only gave me 3. And they were like that big. That hot wing's big. It's fine, everything's fine. So I've had to just put it in with some lettuce and just bulk it up a bit, because otherwise that's just not a dinner. I can't eat that because I actually don't eat KFC chips. Don't particularly like them. So it's fine. It's fine. Listen, KFC knew that I'm in my healthy girl era. Okay, guys, so this is the vibe that I'm going for, like a black cake. See, I love something like this, but like just something with like a drip down the side. It's like a black, I mean this one. Oh my god, that one's so nice. It's like a black gothic cake for her birthday. So we're gonna start off by getting everything iced and started. It's 10 PM. I'm covered in icing. And I still haven't iced the cake. This is proving to be a lot harder than I thought it would be. Now, maybe this is just my ADHD being as inventive as it is, but I had some real issues trying to get the buttercream black. I think I've done it. So it's setting in the fridge at the minute. I pray to God that I've done it, because seriously, otherwise I am gonna give up, because I don't know what further things to do. I had some real issues with it, but now I'm hoping, like I was saying, I'm hoping I've done it. It's in the fridge setting
and then I've got another 15 minutes before it's finished, so. This is what the cake's looking like, guys. Had to recruit mother to help fix the cake because we had a little bit of a disaster, so we're making fondant with it now instead. So, but I'm letting my mum do that because she's the professional. Oh. Obviously, here she goes. Okay. Oh, I thought you put it on.
I will, but hang on.
So she's basically measuring the fondant to the size of the top of the cake. Then put on. That's just very clever. So now we've had to improvise and use purple and black, but I think that looks really cool. It's like a marble type effect. Again, Mumsy's pulling through, but that's what it looks like on the top at the minute. But Mumsy's got it on lock. Mumsy the baker. Guys, after long last, we've got the fondant on the cake, and it looks really cool. I'm really quite proud of us. Mum's making some buttercream over there. I'm making some drip, chocolate drip for the side of the cake. So I'm hoping it will go well. Fingers crossed anyway. Yo guys, this is a completed cake. I think it looks quite cool. How nice is that?
Happy Monday, everyone. So I'm currently making a snack that I saw on TikTok, and it's basically like peanut butter on bananas with melted chocolate, dark chocolate. Because I'm just trying to be a little bit healthier in what I eat, so I thought I'd make a couple of cute little proteiny type snacks. I do actually have spaghetti hoops now, me, so lol. Love that for me. It's bank holiday Monday. So yesterday, I didn't vlog yesterday, but yesterday we went to, me and Connor and some of our friends went to Cambridge for the day. They were doing like a little concert in the park or something, whatever it was. So we just had a little picnic, watched that, just chilled, had a few drinks and thing. A tad hungover today, as you can see. So love that for me, but I had to pull myself up out of bed, stop feeling sorry for myself, and get a few things done. So I've got like a load of washing on, I've had a little tidy up, wash the dishes, and now I'm making these like banana snack things, which I'm quite excited to make, to be honest with you. Because I'm starting to quite like peanut butter. I mean, I never used to like peanut butter, like, at all. I didn't like any of the Snickers or anything like that. Like, I just did not enjoy peanut butter. So, to have a snack with peanut butter in it that I actually like is a rare occurrence. This is what they're looking like at the moment, guys. I think they look quite nice, but we'll see. So I'm gonna put them in the freezer now for about a half an hour just to set. Actually, so cute. I think I left them for a little bit longer than I should have. But yeah, I'm gonna try those now and see what they taste like. Watch a bit of Friends and just chill out.
Good morning. I'm whispering because there's workmen outside, but we are having some air conditioning units put in. Our landlord requested for us to have them because it gets really, really hot in here in the summer and super cold in the winter. So it's cold in the summer. No. So it gives us colder in the summer and hotter in the winter. So they're currently doing it at the moment. I'll show you the progress. So that's where it was going to go. And they put like a little hole in the wall. So that's what that's looking like at the minute. If we go out here, this is what it's looking like up here at the minute. So I've decided to come and have a sunbathe while they're out. Okay, I'm back from a sunbed. not too tanned, but that's okay. I've got my Monster. I am waiting currently for all of my videos to sync from the iCloud so I can edit this, spend a week with me. I've done something very impulsive, but I've finally done it. I've bought a vlogging camera, or I'm buying a vlogging camera. Let me show you. So this is the camera I think I'm gonna buy. It's the Canon G-Shot Power Compact vlogging kit. So that's how much it is. I'm gonna buy this one. So it comes with a tripod, a camera, and an SD card, which just makes my life so much easier. So now I can say goodbye to shit camera quality. And then this light streaky thing that's happening. I'm gonna end the vlog here because I feel like the vlog could just continuously go on forever. So it is now Tuesday evening. So the clips you just saw of me buying my vlog camera was the middle of today. Let me show you the aircon systems first. So this is the first aircon system we've had put in. They are gonna come and board all this up, and I think I am gonna have to rearrange my desk because I can't have that thing in the back of my videos when I'm filming my makeup videos. And then we've got this one, which is quite cool. And they have remotes, and it pumps heat in the winter and cold air in the summer. But the only problem is the day that we get them installed and everything gets working, there was a huge thunderstorm. So we're just coming up to the aftermath of the thunderstorm now, but there was a massive thunderstorm that hit about 4:30, and lightning hit a main supply wire thing. I'm not sure, I'm not the electricity people, but nonetheless, lightning has struck on the main electricity path that comes to my street, and my whole street is out of power. So it means I can't get dinner. I can't do anything. In fact, I have no internet still, so it's 2 hours later. It's 6:30. Still have no internet, still have no power, still have nothing. So it means I can't cook any dinner. So I had to make a call to Connor to tell him to get some food on the way home. Otherwise, we're not eating tonight. Just going to get fish and chips from the local chippy. And that's what Connor's going to get. So we're just going to have that. I don't know when the hell the electricity is going to come back on. In fairness, I've just spent the last hour editing my vlog. This bank holiday weekend vlog, because look at me go. So I started editing that at about 5:30. So it's about 6:30 now. So I've done a little hour of editing this afternoon just to really get ahead on things. So I just want to say thank you so much for watching this vlog, and I'm so sorry yet again that my vlog is super jumpy. Like at the beginning I showed you guys my little trip to Starbucks, but I really wanted to include that in the vlog. So this vlog has actually been quite a long one. Obviously my vlogs are not normally as long as this, so if you have watched the full vlog, thank you so much. But next will be I'll do a little spa vlog, then I will do the Disney experience, and then Zante. So a couple of nice little vlogs coming up on the way with my new vlogging camera, guys. The next time I film a vlog will be on my new camera, and I'm so excited because it just makes me feel like a proper vlogger. I just love doing this, and I'm so proud of myself that I've finally been able to get myself a little vlogging camera after been doing these vlogs for about a year now. Not been very good at it, but listen, that's my 2023 goal, to get better. So I'm so proud of myself that I've finally been able to get myself a proper vlogging camera, so I can start vlogging more. Oh my god. I'm so happy. But yeah, I'm gonna stop rambling on because that's all I do. Thank you so much for watching my videos, guys. If you haven't already, please like, comment and subscribe. It would mean the world to me. And I will see you all in the next one.